board certified, and I'm the vice president of the Syosset Teachers Association. I'm blessed to teach in a district that works tirelessly to support the teachers as we try to make sense out of these Common Core standards for our learners. According to your own task force website, this group was convened to perform a comprehensive review of learning standards, instructional guidance and curricula, and tests to improve implementation and reduce testing anxiety. I can tell you that the learning standards are broken and must be replaced with thoughtful, educator-developed new standards for learning. Instructional guidance and curricula have been flawed at best. The tests are poorly designed, motivated by profits, abusive to children, ineffective in measuring teaching or learning, and a waste of time. We do not have testing anxiety. What you're seeing is anger. Anger at the waste of resources, anger at the excessive time spent in a now narrowed curriculum, anger at the loss of important nuances related to learning in our public schools. And the damage begins early. Our veteran primary teachers have told us that what they must ask their youngest children to do in the classroom is creating gaps, both in academics and motivation. Our special needs students, who often need the most support, are particularly impacted by a set of standards that leads to inflexibility and rigidity in curricula. We're focusing on academic skills too early and at the expense of our littlest ones. In grades 2 and 3, where children traditionally arrive at big learning doorways at different times, during those 2 years, we've lost the ability to support them where they are. Instead, we must rush them through the gates in a very fast journey through curriculum based on the pace set by the standards. Our 4th and 5th graders are required to move at a frenetic pace that ensures no time for deep understanding and reflection. We require a kind of academic hopscotch from one topic to another in order to get everything covered. The priorities of old, fostering a love of learning, of reading, developing citizenship, practicing communication skills, building holistic knowledge of the world and how it works through the arts, has gone out the window. Our veteran teachers, myself included, are being sent to our retirements at the earliest possible moments because we cannot stomach what we must make our students do in order to become compliant with the Common Core standards. We also cannot stomach the way decisions are being made in our profession by corporations and politicians and hedge fund managers with only profits and privatization in mind. I submit to you that the fox is in the hen house, and learning lives of our most precious national treasures have been sold to the highest bidder. The solution: listen, take time, collaborate with educators, reject any voice that speaks from financial gain, uncouple testing from evaluation, respect the professionals who have worked our entire lives to be good at this. You have a moral obligation to do this now. I thank you for your time, and I wish you well as you do the right thing for children.
My name is Christine Tansky. I have a whole speech prepared here, but I much everybody else here has given such amazing testimony that I'm going to actually scrap my speech and tell you a story instead that probably nobody else.
Why don't you submit your speech?
It's been submitted.
As a written form.
Online and written. Excellent. An extra copy. My story actually began 2 years ago today on November 6, 2013. That was the day that my son had a nervous breakdown. He was diagnosed with anxiety and depression, school related. He was put on homebound instruction for the remainder of the school year. Up until that point, he was a straight A-B student. He was involved in sports and clubs, he was in chorus. He liked to go to school early every day to actually do extra help and do extra things, whether it was working on scenery for a play or going to chorus or just meeting up with friends or helping his teacher early in the morning. Suddenly I had a son who I couldn't wake up, I couldn't get him out of bed. No matter what I did, no matter what I said, it just wasn't good enough. He lost his smile, he lost his affect. There was nothing left to my child. Here I am exactly 2 years later, and I have to say, it's been 2 long years of doctor's appointments, therapists, digging, researching, networking, speaking to other parents, and like Mrs. Lichtenstein, meeting other people and hearing other people's testimony and seeing, you know what, I'm not alone. I made a vow to my son back then, I'm gonna find the cause, and I'm gonna find the cure, and I will not quit until we find the cure and we put an end to this. 2 years later, I cannot believe I'm still standing here fighting this. I had so much hope when John King was giving his first listening tour. I cheered, I stood outside in the overflow. I listened to Beth Dimino talk and I chomped on my table. I mean, when is enough going to be enough? How many casualties do we need to have before we say, stop Common Core, put an end to it? Now, one person here so far that has spoken has been in support. I'm begging you, I'm pleading with you, as a parent, please remember our faces, remember our needs. We're gonna remember yours at the end of all of this. Remember our stories. We've given up our time, Maggie and I came here straight from work today. I haven't stopped all day. We're here. We're here for a reason. We're not hysterical white suburban moms. We have normal life. Difference. Be our children's heroes. Thank you.
Yay, Christine!